Hi, and welcome to the first video in our series of tutorials aimed at helping you find, visualize, map, and report data in AWQMS, DEQ's Water Quality Monitoring Data Portal. The tutorials in the series are not meant to be followed in any specific order, so feel free to jump to the topic or topics you feel would be most useful. The series of videos is tailored to AWQMS version 8.0. However, the software is updated periodically, which may change or add functionality to AWQMS. The main functionality described in these videos will likely remain the same, but if you encounter an issue, please feel free to email the address shown here. The topic of this tutorial is getting started, and we'll provide a very brief background of AWQMS, point out helpful information on our webpage, and walk through the signing in process. First, AWQMS, or the Ambient Water Quality Monitoring System, allows for easy access to DEQ and partner data for rivers, streams, lakes, estuaries, beaches, and groundwater resources throughout Oregon. When using AWQMS, it is important to keep in mind that water quality data posted on this website were generated to satisfy specific data quality objectives for the programs and projects under which they were generated. Portion of the samples were analyzed and/or collected by organizations other than DEQ. Review of the non-DEQ data is limited to information supplied by the non-DEQ organizations. The users of the data obtained here must understand the potential limitations of the data and determine the data's suitability for their intended uses. In addition, AWQMS provides a direct exchange to the EPA's Water Quality Exchange Network. AWQMS is a read-only portal, and the public is not able to create new monitoring locations, add or modify any data. However, if you are interested in collaborating with DEQ in water quality data collections, please visit our volunteer monitoring webpage shown here. Now, before we jump into AWQMS, I'd like to point out a couple of helpful items on the Water Quality Data Monitoring webpage. First, this hyperlink text that says Access AWQMS will take you to the AWQMS sign-in page. Below that, you can see the username and password for the account. Next is a hyperlink to an email address, which you can use if you have any questions about using AWQMS or run into issues finding data. This email address goes to multiple people, so you should receive a response fairly quickly. The final item I'd like to point out is the list of available data in AWQMS. We are continually uploading data, and this list is updated periodically. Now let's get signed in. I'm going to click the Access AWQMS text and head over to the AWQMS main page. Here I'll enter the public account username and password. After successfully signing in, we land on the AWQMS homepage, where you can see four tabs for graphs, maps, reports, and exports. Searching for data is the same under each of these tabs, and you can move between the tabs without having to recreate your search each time, which can be very helpful. We'll talk about the different ways to search for data in our next video. If you have any questions about this video, please feel free to email the address shown here. Thank you for watching.